factor trinomials without a leading coefficient. So if the leading coefficient, which is the number in front of the x squared term, is a 1, then the two numbers, or in other words, the two factors of the last term will add or subtract, depending on whether we're adding or subtracting, to the middle term. This makes these really easy and quick to do, but this only works if the leading coefficient is 1. So let's take a look at our two examples. In example 1, notice we have the invisible 1 there. So I get to put my x's in for free, is how I think about it. My factors, we're going to be subtracting. So we're looking at factors of 8 that when I take the difference give me 2. Only one set does that, that's 2 and 4. I want to have a negative 2, so that means my 4 has to be negative, my 2 has to be positive. Now if you want to check this with what we were doing before with our outside times the inside, this would give us a negative 4x plus 2x, which gives me negative 2. This is my check. And this is my answer. And we got it really quick and easy. If on this one, we still have our leading coefficient as 1, but notice I have the y involved. So sometimes it's really nice when you have that second variable just to throw it in there at the very beginning so that you don't forget it. My last term is negative, so that means I'm going to be subtracting my factors. And so factors of 8 that when I take the difference give me 7. Well, we only have two sets of factors. We either have 2 and 4 or we have 1 and 8. The only one that gives me a difference of 7 is 1 and 8, so I'm going to use 1 and 8. I want a positive 7, so that means my larger number has to be positive, so my smaller one negative. Again, I can do my quick check here. I would have a positive xy minus 1xy, which would give me a positive 7xy. It checks. We're good. There's my answer.